Hi guys, welcome to my latest Elite Dangerous video. Today I'm going to be having a look at refueling missions. I was just scanning the Gurney Slade system to make a couple of credits when I stumbled across this distress call here. The last time I did one of these, I found a capital ship and a bunch of other ships which had been attacked and incapacitated. Judging by the green fog around the site, I presume that they'd got into an argument with the Thargoids. It's pretty crazy how much damage those pesky wee aliens can do, because these are some quite capable ships which have been taken out here. And I know I'm potentially at risk here as well, because that there in front of me is the same ship I'm in. So this was much more than a normal NPC attack which a corvette would just shrug off. And if that behemoth also couldn't cope with the attackers, then I doubt I would stand a chance. And I was expecting this new one to be more of the same, but it turned out to be quite different. I didn't save anyone at that previous distress call, but I did collect me some lovely cargo, including some classified military documents, which nearly got me into trouble next time I docked at a station, because they're actually illegal. So I've now arrived at the location of the distress call. Let's see what's here. I've got a vague signal on my radar behind me. Let's also check whether anything is showing up on the left-hand panel. I didn't see anything obvious there. I guess I just fly in the general direction of that thing on the radar then. Might have to locate this one visually if it's a low energy source. I think I see something just left of center up ahead.
At last! Please tell me you have some spare fuel. I miscalculated the length of my journey and now I'm dry.
Noob. That's the sort of incompetent thing I do. Ah well, I'm in a good mood, so let's see if we can talk to them. Maybe nag them about fitting a fuel scoop to their ship or something as well. Funny how the adder feels like a decent sized chip when you first upgrade to it, and now it looks more like a little shuttlecraft or something. I'll try scanning them. That did a lot. Anything in the comms panel? Nope. Well, I guess I should also just have a look whether I'm carrying anything that might be able to help. I know I don't have any limpets, but maybe I can just drop hydrogen for them? I've never refueled anyone before, so I don't know for certain, but I have a feeling I won't have any hydrogen on me other than what's in my fuel tank. Yeah, no hydrogen in my inventory as expected, so am I able to synthesize some? I really doubt it, considering it's the second most basic element in the universe. Doesn't look like it. I can synthesize fuel for the SRV, but not for my ship. Maybe I won't be able to help. I'll try the comms panel again in case I missed something. Nothing in my inbox, but there's now something on the chat tab. I'm sure that wasn't there when I checked a second ago. Mission rewards are a small increase in reputation and an even smaller amount of credits. If I ignore this, I'm sure I'll avoid the risk of reputation decrease, but I'm really curious to see what happens when I accept the mission. I don't know when I'll find another one of these. So I've accepted it, and they're saying thank you and promising to write a song about me.
Thank you so much. I'll write a song about you when I get to port.
Is this how the economics of the 34th century works? People pay for things in song form? Hopefully it's not going to be a bloody sea shanty. I'll just give her a hint that I can't currently help her. One of the verses will have to be about how I don't actually have any limpets on me right now, and send. No response back. That's pretty ignorant. Maybe I'll just leave her here then. Let's try negotiating instead. I can't give her any fuel, but how about I could give you a bump start? Again, no response. Okay. If I was really nice, I'd go buy limpets and come back. Is there actually a station in this system? I have no idea whether I can wake away from here without failing the mission, but I might as well try, if there is one. How did they not even have enough fuel to cover 0.15 light seconds? That's only about 45,000 kilometres. Assuming 250 kilometres an hour, that's not even a week's flight. She's lucky though, I'm feeling kind, and I want to hear that song she's going to write about me. Next stop, Adkins Terminal. I might grab myself a sandwich while I'm there. She's not going anywhere anytime soon.
Frameshift drive charging. 4, 3, 2, 1, engage.
Time for an edit, methinks. Fortunately, I know I have an empty module slot in this ship, and it's a size 6, so there's definitely room to add the limpet controller I'll need to do this mission. Adkins, are you ready to dock? And it's off to outfitting we go to look at limpets. Hopefully they stock the kind I need. Fuel transfer limpets? Perfect! Exactly what I was looking for. Now, do I really want to spend 750,000 on this? I think the cheaper type will be more than enough, and that leaves me enough credits to buy 1 ton of sandwiches. I'll just eat that on my journey back to her. And while the docking computer takes me out of the station, hopefully, I'll use that time to set up a fire group with the limpet controller in it. I also bought some limpets from Advanced Maintenance, but I could have synthesized them too if I'd forgotten to buy them here. This sandwich is nice. Space cheese and space pickle, my favorite. Let's see if that distress call is still on the nav panel, hopefully. Yep, they haven't moved, so we'll just lock that as a target again. And you can see up top right that I've still got 19 minutes to rescue them. That confirms to me that I didn't fail the mission by flying away to grab my fuel transfer limpets. All good, and we're back again. Let's just head towards the half signal on the radar until we can see her again. Should be in front of us somewhere. I don't see her, but she must be there somewhere. When I get close enough, hopefully she'll hail me again. Come on, Vlad. Where are you? Got some fuel for you. To quote Captain Picard, come out, wherever you are.
At last. Please tell me you have some spare fuel. I miscalculated the length of my journey and now I'm dry.
Huh? Where did Vlad go? She's transitioned into a guy and now goes by the name of Gretchev, it would seem. Looks like the way you pay for fuel is not the only thing which has changed in the future. This is a bit weird. Same mission, but different person and different ship. Still, I came here to do a job and I don't really care who I save. I bought these limpets and I intend to use them. Since it's a different ship, I think I'll try scanning it again, just in case I get any encoded data materials this time. Nope, nothing again. I kind of expected that, to be honest. Fuel limpets ready and standing by. Let's see if this guy is any more talkative than Vlad Paler was. It's a new mission.
Thank you so much. I'll write a song about you when I get to port.
Well, first of all, what is it with you guys and songs? No reply? Okay then, well, I better state my terms and conditions. Just don't make it a sea shanty, all right? I take the silence as confirmation. And no power ballads either. It's got to be careful. And then there's one more thing I want to ask Gretchen about. Also, weren't you a girl 5 minutes ago? Ooh, awkward silence. That's maybe not an appropriate conversation subject in the 34th century.
Programming limpet drone.
I'll just fire some fuel over to him or her and say no more.
Programming limpet drone. Transferring fuel. Programming limpet drone. Transferring fuel. Transferring fuel.
Hopefully they'll be so glad of the fuel they'll forget I asked about the whole gender change thing.
Looks like we're back in business. Thanks, Commander. I hope I can repay the favor someday.
Well, it all seems to be water under the bridge now. Hopefully they'll also forget to write that horrible song they threatened me with. I'm wondering whether I should take that risk, considering I could just blow them out of the sky now and be on the safe side. Nope. Lost them. Eagle is way too fast. I could scan their wake and chase them down. But then they'd still be too fast for me at conventional speeds, so I have to let them go. I'm gonna scan this anyway because it's free encoded data materials, which is good for engineering. I overshoot these things every single time. It's really quite annoying. Just need more practice, I guess. As with so many things, gotta get good. Looks like I'm in position now. Scanning.
Oh well, that was quite fun. I transferred fuel and the job was done. The little ship has flown away to fight another day.
Got eccentric hyperspace trajectories. That'll do nicely. So that's how you do the refueling thing. Pretty straightforward, really. And we've come to the end of this video. If you've enjoyed it, please comment, leave a like, subscribe, and watch the other videos on my channel. But most importantly, until next time, fly safe.